Hello everyone, it's Jess Hartz, and today we are building the Addams Family Mansion, and that includes the lake, the graveyard, and the whole underground vault, secret passages and everything, even Lurch's bedroom. Now, first, let's chat, then we'll talk about the history of the Addams Family. So how have you guys been? I swear it's been ages since we've had a nice chill chat, but yes, I spoke a while ago about some tea, and honestly it's nothing that intense. It's a big deal to me though. I got my tattoos done. I got my sunflowers, or what I call them, my sunny boys. I am so happy with them, and my tattoo artist is awesome. I went with one of my best friends, so she held my hand the entire time. I plan on going alone, but I'm so glad she was there. So my first tattoo was like nothing. She didn't hurt whatsoever, but my sunflowers were on the end of my collarbone, and if you know anything about tattoos, you will know anywhere on the bone hurts like a mofo. So yeah, it hurt while he was outlining, but the shading was fine. I think it took around like 3-ish hours. I can't remember properly, but my tattoo artist and another person who was getting tattooed, as well as their tattoo artist, all started chatting about Minecraft. So yeah, we all started nerding out. It was pretty hilarious. And I was giving my tattoo artist some tips and stuff about how to start your own village. So yeah, that was really fun. And I have wanted these tattoos for years, and I mean years, a long ass time. And I love them so much. And before I get questions asking what do they mean that I love sunflowers. And just, yeah, I think I've always wanted them. Originally, back when I was quite, like, young, I wanted roses, but then I quickly changed my mind. I'm like, sunflowers, they're my favorite. I love how they look. They remind me of just being warm and cozy. But yeah, without further ado, I think it's time we get into the history of the Addams Family. So, this story begins circa 1938 with Charles Samuel Addams. He was an American cartoonist, and he was the one who came up with the Addams Family, and the cartoon strip was originally in the New Yorker. Of course, the family consisted of Gomez, Morticia, the daughter Wednesday, and son Pugsley, whom I just found out had a pet octopus named Aristotle, which is amazing, and of course Grandmama, Uncle Fester, and Lurch, who is their butler, as well as Thing the Hand and Cousin It, the sentient mound of hair. Apparently, at first, the family members didn't actually have names originally. Pretty much the family was an inverted version of the ideal family at the time in America. So, you know, a bit twisted. Something I've often seen is the theory why Morticia and Gomez are so loving and supportive and passionate is because they're the opposite of what most relationships were at the time. Bit of shade. Anyway, the family pretty much encapsulate everything dark and macabre. Instead of a vase of roses, Morticia would prune the flowers off and stick the stems in the vase. Instead of a nicely cleaned house, it was filled with cobwebs and spiders, among other things. Something I love about the Addams is that they have a family cemetery on their land. Mind you, they also kept Uncle Knickknack in the closet in the attic, but you know, potato potato. Oh yes, and they were fabulously wealthy. But it's when 1964 comes around on the 8th of April when we first see them come to the television. And that's also when we hear the iconic theme song that we all know and love, with the original Lurch, or Ted Cassidy, saying the rememberable words, neat, sweet, petite. And not gonna lie, as I'm writing the script down, my boyfriend and I are singing the theme song. She a catchy mofo. I digress. The black and white TV show burst onto the scene, starring beautiful Carolyn Jones as Morticia and John Aston as Gomez. This was my first memorable interaction with the Addams Family. I was on the ground as a little kid in my living room, and I think it was like a rerun special or something, and I remember a gnarly scene of them all sitting there with the dude's brain exposed, like they were cutting open his skull. Either it was the Addams Family or some weird stuff was on the telly at daytime. The family live in a second empire style mansion, and I really want you to go look up that style of home because they are a favourite of mine. Beautiful style of architecture. Once again, the Addams Family is inverse of what the typical family was like then. They are never nasty though to their guests or other members of the community, which I love. Mind you, in the first 1991 film, you do see them pouring something hot out of a cauldron onto some carolers, but Carol is really annoying, from what I've heard. Anyway, they think that their out-of-the-norm way of living is in fact normal for everyone, and are often shocked by people's negative responses to them. Kind of like the Frankenstein's monster scenario. Something I found out in watching some of these series and researching is that Grandmama isn't Morticia's sister originally. Maybe that's common knowledge that she's in fact Gomez and Festa's mother in the original series. But Morticia has an older sister, Ophelia Frump, whom is the polar opposite of Morticia. She's a bit of a hippy-dippy, a bit of a flower childish, and she is known, of course, as the white sheep of the family because of this. Originally, Gomez was engaged to Ophelia in an arranged marriage, but, you know, he, like, sees Morticia in that 1920s cartoonish way. He gets some heart eyes for her. Morticia and Ophelia's mother is Hester Frump, who I fangirled over because she plays the Wicked Witch of the West in The Wizard of Oz. What a lad. Her character, like Grandmama, is also a witch. The TV show ran for 2 seasons till 1966. The writers committed to making sure the characters were fully embodied in Charles' original concept, which is something I really liked and respected. Being so, they really did capture the hearts of many, including my dad. He watched them briefly as a child, as well as the Munsters. As time went on, many adaptations of the Addams Family came and went, from the new Scooby-Doo movies in 1972, where the original cast of the TV show came back for a special. The Addams Family Funhouse aired a year later, but wasn't picked up after the pilot. From what I can find out, it was a weird musical variety show that the family hosted. Yeah, kind of no shock it didn't stick. An animated series of the Addams Family came onto the scene in 1973 and ran for 2 years. And this particular rendition was a little different because the Addams Family were on a road trip in an RV. This series is also where relationships in the family would change. Grandmama is now Morticia's mother, not Gomez's. It seems that the family relations jump around a bit, which I'm not gonna lie. Why? Like, I'm assuming budgeting and lack of voice actors had to do with it, but we shall never know. This series didn't seem to do very well, and the complimentary comic book series that was connected to the show didn't seem to get much love either. Bit rough, eh? Before doing this video, I had no idea what an up and down life the Addams Family had. Kind of weird, I guess kind of fitting as well. Of course, another 2 series came after this in the 90s, and once again, didn't really seem to be as loved as the later movies. The TV movie Halloween with the new Addams Family came out prior to 1977, and was a reunion of the original live action series. We learn that Gomez actually has an older brother, Pancho? I can't pronounce these words. Who, of course, once had a thingy, flirty whoop-whoop with Morticia. Honestly, this family. The plot of the movie is that Gomez is clearly jealous of his older brother, Pancho, and that Halloween is on its way, which I'm assuming is the best time and busiest time of year for the Addams Family. I also just found out that this movie and the series is on Hulu, so I'm so tempted to go watch everything on there. As with the original live action series and movie, they both received a cult classic status, and honestly, that's no surprise. And then something magical happened. In 1991, the Addams Family movie was released, and I'm more than certain most of us have either seen it or loved it. The beautiful and amazing Angelica Houston starred as Morticia Raul Julia, I can't pronounce his name either, starred as Gomez. Cool couple, as everyone know. Little side note, if y'all ever want some tea about Angelica Houston, look her up in Jack Nicholson. I read all about them like a few months ago and it broke my heart because I am such a fan of their acting and yeah. Anyway, the beautiful Christina Ricci starred as the ever idolized by little goths everywhere, Wednesday, and Jimmy Workman as Pugsley. But who the heck could forget Christopher Lloyd as Festa? Yes, the same Christopher Lloyd who played Doc in Back to the Future. An all-star cast. The film was heavily based on the original cartoon and a long-term favourite of mine. The plot in this movie is that Gomez is saddened by the 25th anniversary of the absence of his brother Festa, after they had a little tiff. After the family, as well as Gomez's lawyer and his wife, perform a seance led by Grandmama, a miracle happens and Festa comes to the door. But it's not as happy ending as I make it seem. There's something more sinister and cunning afoot. Due to this film's great success, of course, there was a sequel in 1993 with the same all-star cast. The Addams Family Values was released. And in my opinion, one of the most hated characters struts onto the scene, Debbie. It's revealed at the end of the first movie that Gomez and Morticia are expecting, so in stride, the beginning of the sequel is Morticia giving birth to their new baby, son, Hubert. Like most older siblings, Wednesday and Pugsley take issue, probably because Wednesday tells Pugsley that when another child is born, the other has to die. So yeah, they try to kill little old Pubert. You know, normal childhood. So Gomez and Morticia are suggested that they put the kids in camp. Camp Chippewa. This place creeps the heck out of me. In my opinion, our second most hated character waddles in, Mercedes McNabb. Yep, she's the kind of girl I would have argued with in high school. She becomes Wednesday's enemy at Camp Chippewa. And all while this is happening, Debbie is flirting and seducing her way into Uncle Festus' heart. And without revealing too much for everyone who hasn't seen the movie, let's just say the Black Widow is in this movie. But there is some sad news. The third movie was all scripted, but unfortunately Raul Julia, or Gomez, passed away, so it was abandoned. Which just broke my heart. I found that out a few years ago about him passing, and I was just so in love with the idea of him, like Morticia and Gomez, and it just, and then the whole idea was abandoned. Like, you know, he's not like a dog, he's not Lassie, you can't just replace him. Anyway, let's skip ahead to a lighter note. I feel like a massively fitting actor plays Gomez in this movie, the amazing Tim Curry. He followed the style of Julia's Gomez, and the movie is called The Addams Family Reunion, and it was released in 1998. I need to see this movie, it looks pretty hilarious. The plot of this movie seems pretty funny. Gomez's parents have developed Waltzheimer's disease, and this disease is turning them normal. So, not spooky or kooky. So Gomez arranges a family reunion in the hopes that a relative can fix the disease. But the company that's sorting it all out hecks up and misspells the last name, so they end up at the wrong Addams Family event. So yeah, they did an oopsie. This movie looks great in that it's so bad that it's good kind of way, but that's just from a cover of the book point of view. I really, really want to watch this. But in 2010, another sad thing occurs. Did you guys know that they were going to make a stop-motion animated film based on the original Charles Addams drawings? And Tim Burton was set to help direct, co-produce, co-direct, all that kind of stuff. I am so annoyed. It was cancelled in 2013. Now, like, I'm gonna touch on this later more when I talk about the latest adaptation, but just imagine with your mind's eye what an Addams Family movie in the style of The Nightmare Before Christmas or The Corpse Ride could look like. Imagine how sick that would be. Ugh. But yes, it could be a possibility one day, we never know. But as we now know, the Addams Family has been going on for 83 years. That's a better half of a century. So of course, there is bound to be heaps of homages and adaptations and little snippets throughout media, and way too many to talk about. But something I didn't even think of was the video games. In 1989, we got Festus Quest, a top-down adventure game. In 1992, The Addams Family, based on the 1991 movie. 93, Pugsley Scavenger Hunt. And in 1994, The Addams Family Values, the new Addams Family series, and a few more. So many games. I'm not gonna lie, I'd adore an Addams Family game in the style of like Alice Madness Returns. If you don't know what that is, go look it up. I love that game so much. It's an immersive platformer, but that's not what we're talking about today. No doubt there were a few books written about the Addams Family, and I'm looking to buy a couple on Amazon right now. The books are The Addams Family, The Addams Family Strikes Back, and The Addams Family and Evolution. I hope to gosh none of you are trying to play a drinking game every time I say The Addams Family, because y'all would get really sick. Anyway, 2019 crashes onto the scene, and I hope everyone's had a good year. It's nearly the end, and that's just bonkers to me. It's gone so fast. But we still have one last adaptation to talk about, The Addams Family 2019 animated movie. What's weird is that I've seen a couple of people saying they've seen it, and I'm like, girl, she don't release till December 5th. So either they're confused or bad liars, but I highly suggest you go look at the trailers if you haven't seen it somehow yet. Now, a lot of people aren't happy about this movie. I'm presuming a lot of those people are older than me or my age, so you know, the people who grew up with the originals. The style is very similar to Despicable Me, and I love those movies and kids' movies in general, if I'm being real. The plot sounds pretty good, to be honest. The family is chased off by an angry mob and they end up in New Jersey because, and I quote, it's a place no one would be caught dead in. Oof, shade. They end up finding the classic mansion, which is an abandoned asylum, and they meet the adorable Lurch when Thing, the disembodied hand, hits him with their car. And after 13 years, it shows them living their best lives. Something that kind of annoys me about these adaptations, and a musical I once saw. Yes, I saw an Addams Family musical. It was terrible. They always make Wednesday into this girl who wants to be normal or was normal curious, and I'm like, Wednesday is a dark, gloomy, and cunning young lady. Stop making her into Regina George. I don't know, it sounds very Addams Family, this movie, and the art style I'm okay with, but like I said earlier, I would have loved more of a Tim Burton style. But something I've thought about is that this is refreshing the Addams Family name for all the new kids on the block. If you're anything like me, you looked up to Morticia and Wednesday, you love the aesthetic and everything that comes along with it. Dark, gloomy, and a bit spoopy. I love how a new generation is being introduced to this. A whole new era of goth babies. I'm down. I'm also down because Cousin It in this movie looks like a damn beast. Let me know what your opinion is of the new movie. And something to remember is that newer renditions won't ruin the old ones. They remain the same and in your heart. I gotta remember that too, whether it comes to games like The Sims, to movies like Harry Potter. But here it is, the complete history of pretty much all I could find about the Addams Family. I hope you all enjoy this little history lesson, and I hope wherever you are, you're having a lovely Halloween October. Unfortunately, where I live, Halloween is pretty much non-existent, which is a pain, but I can still party on my own spooky self. It's actually around Christmas I get a bit more spoopy, and most of you are probably like, what the hell, girl? Stop mixing holidays together, you're not Jack Skellington. And that's legit what I do. I might get some photos up later on down the track when I decorate, but I decorate my whole house in the Christmas decor, of course, but I give it a spooky twist. A few Christmases ago, I sat on my bedroom floor and painted a bunch of my baubles into eyeballs and gave them bat wings. I made cardboard bats to hang on the walls with separate cardboard Santa hats. Yes, I made them separate so they can chill on my wall all year round, and then they put the little hats on in the 1st of December. Oh, I'm such a nerd. Nah, let's be real, it's around the 20th of November. I love holidays and celebrations, if you can't tell. Like, my boyfriend is the opposite, but he thinks it's hella cute whenever I get into the holiday mode. I just go nuts, and I like to think I turn him into less of a Scrooge. And I know I shouldn't be talking about, like, Christmas when it ain't even Halloween officially yet, but whatever, I do what I want. But I thought we might just chat and catch up a little bit at the end of the history lesson because, well, heck, there's a lot of video and not as much history. But for those asking, my puppy Milo is doing great. He's around five-ish months old now, and he's beautiful and a sneaky little boy. I woke up to him snuggled up around my belly this morning, and he was doing a little snore. Ah, oh, he's so beautiful and too sweet. I wish he sat on my lap still, because back in the day, he used to sit on my lap when I was recording these voiceovers. It was too cute. But it's Halloween in only a few days, and I got my little boy a pair of bat wings that he can wear, and he really doesn't mind wearing them, to be honest. He does run around a lot, though. I might pop them on him for a little while and take some photos later on, but other than that, I'll be working on, hopefully, the last Halloween video for you guys. But I'm also working on something very near and dear to my heart for you guys. Let me know if you'd like a little trailer for it. It is a series, so keep that in mind. There will, of course, be some buildings, but your girl wants to play. But hopefully I'll be watching some spoopy stuff with my boyfriend on Thursday and playing some video games. Oh my god, how could I forget? Okay, so two things. I started the Fable series again, and I'm around halfway through Fable 3 at the moment, and I am loving it. Like, I love Fable 1 and Fable 2 and Fable 3. Fable 4 we don't talk about. I definitely want to build some Fable inspired builds for you guys, and the vast majority of you are coming up in winter, so it'd be perfect for these styles of buildings. But if you don't know what Fable is, girl, do yourself a favor and look it up. It's amazing. It's such a good series. If you love Fable as well, there's a pretty funny Facebook group I'm part of called Guild Posting. Lame as heck, I know, but it's super fun and nice finding other people who nerd out about the same things you do, as well as turning them into memes. So something else that's been going on in my life is that I've pretty much changed change my whole diet. So I'm eating healthy as heck and I'm feeling great. Longtime viewers will know I used to live for going for a walk daily, but now I do some cycling and aerobics every single morning for an hour. And yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know that I've been doing really good. I feel healthier and happier. I know I don't talk about this stuff a lot, but I do struggle with mental health a bit and blah, blah, blah. I might dive into that whole thing another time because she's a whole video in herself. But I hope you guys are well, and I'm always here if you want to DM me on Twitter or just in the comments. I'm sure some other lovely people might chime in also. But yeah, I thought you guys would like to know I'm not disappearing or nothing bad has happened, but I have been super busy and these big movie TV show builds take so damn long, but I love them so much. But to be honest, I cannot wait to go and be creative again though, if you feel me, like where I just think of a house and then I build it. So I'm not like taking photos and like trying to analyze this house and then recreate it. I love doing that, but at the same time I'm like, oh, I just want to build this or I want to build that. And it's been forever since I've done a modern home, I swear to gosh. Also, before the video ends, I thought I'd talk about that tiny house challenge I did like months ago. I am so sorry guys, but I am talking with a couple of my friends who do streaming and I definitely want to start streaming. Should I do Twitch or Mixer? And I thought maybe one of the first or the first streams I should do is touring your entries to the tiny home challenge. Better late than never. I still feel awful about that. I think it was during the whole Edith Finch scenario. Okay, so a little backstory there. When I first uploaded the finished photo of the Edith house, I was contacted by a lovely journalist from PC Gamer, and pretty much she didn't rush me, but I was worried that if I didn't have all the videos out in time, the whole situation would have gotten hecked up. And I won't lie to you guys, I stressed myself out way too much during that build. Like, it's no surprise, it's such a massive build, but it's just a game, like, come on. But I let it get to my head, and I got so over it by the end. I still love the game so much, but I can tell you now that I know that story like the back of my hand. I'm good, sis. But I think all of the stresses there, and the crazy explosion of views that I got out of, like, nowhere, really tripped me out a little bit, like, whoa. And I was getting some hella negative feedback online, and surprisingly it didn't affect me too much, but I wanted to get out the second video as quickly as possible to, like, you know, give those people the middle finger almost. And of course a lot of negative feedback was because of, oh, it's The Sims, it's not a real game, that whole spiel. Like, what constitutes a real game? Like, one where you shoot lizards and smoke a cigar? I don't know. But yes, that's a big reason why the touring video is behind. And the silly thing is, it's legit probably one of my favorite videos to do. Like, obviously it doesn't get as many views as my other videos, but seeing all of you guys get so creative, it's just so inspiring and I love it so much. And like the little details, like when I did that spooky challenge and somebody had written spook and some lights in a closet, I just love that. It's just so, I don't know, it's wholesome as. And I spoke earlier about how this year has gone so fast, and it really has, because like every time I go to do a tour video or I have an awesome idea, a new Sims trailer comes out and everyone's freaking out about that. Or it's suddenly October and I want to make good on the promises to make a bunch of Halloween inspired houses, which I haven't done properly. Like, I was going to do one every single week. I was going to also do an autumn inspired build that same week as well, so two videos a week. And I just have been so busy and so caught up in it all, and it's so, like, I should have chosen like smaller spooky houses to build, but my dumb butt decided on doing like big ones, so obviously they take up so much more time. And don't get me wrong, I want to do all these videos and builds because it makes me so happy, but it's so overwhelming, if you feel me. I had an idea last night when I couldn't sleep like properly because my brain was like, oh, what about this, what about that. Now I know some of you might not like these people, but obviously the Shane Dawson and the Jeffree Star series is going off its head, and I love Jeffree's makeup collection. I've turned back to my old ways and I love makeup again despite barely wearing it. Like, back in the day I was so addicted to makeup, and I haven't really worn makeup properly in around 3-ish years, 4 years. Yeah, like not even a smidge, maybe a little bit of mascara, but that was it. But yeah, I've turned back to my old ways. I love makeup again a lot, but I just don't wear it because I have nowhere to go. But I'm so tempted to build Jeffrey's house. It is so beautiful on the outside and it's so pink on the inside. It's, like he says, very iconic. Plus, I also really want to make that pink fabric wall somehow. But yeah, y'all should let me know if that's something you'd like to see, especially with the launch of the Conspiracy Palette on the way. She's all happening. But yeah, guys, I hope you liked the history deep dive on the Addams Family, and I hoped you liked the little D&M at the end and catch up. Oh, and importantly, I hope you guys like the build. It's a bit of the original and the 1991 and 93 movies. It's under Jess Hart's on the gallery, and there is no CC. Have a great night or day, guys, but I gotta get going, so remember to subscribe, like and comment, tick that bell, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!